Hey guys, it is Tonya, Thrifty Treasures. Welcome to another video. So today is going to be the first video in a brand new series that Angie with Treasured Vintage and I are going to be doing. It's going to be called Jewelry Detectives, and we are going to be having guests on who would like to learn more about the jewelry that they've picked up at the thrift stores or garage sales, and we are going to do our best to help them figure out what they have. And we're also going to be doing some learning ourselves in the process, right? I have pen and paper. I know I'm going to be taking notes. So, Angie?
Hi, everybody. I'm Angie, Treasured Vintage, and I'm going to be learning along with all of you.
Lonnie?
Oh, hello, guys. I'm sorry. I was waiting for my cue. But my name's Lonnie. I have a YouTube channel called Garage Flips, and I don't really know that much about jewelry, but I would like to learn too. Today, if you have questions, ask them in the chat. I'll be pulling questions out of chat and asking the experts here, and hopefully we can all learn together. Thanks so much for the invite, guys. Appreciate
it. Thanks for helping us. StevenSteph.
Hi.
Hi.
We're StevenSteph Resale Killers, and we're the non-experts. We're the complete jewelry amateurs. We know nothing about jewelry. Like literally nothing.
Didn't stop us from getting one of these though.
But what inspired us to get one of these is watching Treasured Vintage and Thrifty Treasures when they were doing all their little jewelry stuff. It looked like so much fun. And we want to know, everything about reselling. So we need to at least get our feet wet with some jewelry, get the jewelry bug.
Right, right. So how long have you guys had that jar?
A couple years.
It's gotta be over a month. Maybe a month and a half. I don't know. We bought it and it's just been staring at us, just looming, just staring. We got it at Savers.
It was one of the first times we had watched one of the jewelry jar videos that you guys do. And then we were just like, hey, let's give that a shot.
We should do it.
It looks so easy. We probably can find gold super easy. Look at it.
And then we've just been terrified and ignoring it. It's just been sitting there procrastinating, not wanting.
Well, Steve, you know what? You say we may find gold, but as soon as I started getting a little interested, I found gold at a garage sale because of these two. They kind of planted that bug, and I found I think it was, about $150 worth of gold.
Wow.
For $5.
That's amazing.
I think I saw that video, Lonnie. And then did you follow that up with the testing that – video?
Yeah, that's the stuff. Yeah, that's the same stuff.
Okay. And that was your first like conscious effort to go try to find it?
Yes, and it was because of these two characters.
Wow.
Right here,
Well,
so hopefully we get lucky like that.
When we first started reselling, we actually bought the whole little thing, the whole jewelry thing. We got a little teeny scale. Wherever I put it, a little baby scale.
Is it that thing?
Yeah, this little guy. You know, cute little scale. We've never used this ever. We got our little loop. They're still never been taken out.
That looks just like mine. It's probably the $5 special, just like mine.
Exactly. We got the little testing kit. I have it in this old floppy drive case, but we have the jewelry things. I mean, the little testing kits.
Ooh, y'all have acids.
Yeah, we got all the stuff. Just
the acids. They last.
We've never done it.
I guess acid isn't.
Yeah, I think you're supposed to keep them in a dark place, and they'll last a little bit longer.
Okay, those have been in a cupboard for a long.
That's a good place to have them. Yeah,
we've had them for years.
I remember Bonnie saying we were talking about silver one time, and Bonnie was saying that the silver acid doesn't last as long as the other ones. I don't know.
That's good to know.
Okay. How do we know that it's expired? That's what I want to know. Like, how do you know it didn't work? You test something that you know it's silver.
I guess the only way would be, just like any other test, would be to have known good pieces to test it against, you know, like a control.
Yeah, that's a good idea, Lonnie.
So the day before you test it, the day you had this big haul of silver, you're like, it's not, throw it away.
Throw it.
then you realize the next day, that's when you test it.
Right. Okay. So how much did you guys pay for your jewelry jar?
$300.
You overpaid. Let me just
tell you. We paid $29.99 and then had 30% off.
We had 30% off of that.
At Savers.
It was the only one. The only one at Savers. And you know what? We would have bought it even without the discount because
we wanted to do this.
We're pretty naive. We just assumed. And there was a guy, like, we were at the checkout, and this guy, and not the stereotype pickers or anything, but he looked like a hardcore picker. And he kept walking back and forth, and then he came up to me and he said, "You guys are gonna do good on that." That's what he told me.
Pretty and sure he was an employee.
No, it was Yosemite Sam in the flesh. And seriously, but he just leaned in and told me that, and I believe him. So
yeah, you know, anytime anybody's ever told me that, "You're gonna do good on that," I've seen those, so I started getting nervous. Because why didn't that dude buy it, right?
It's usually when you're at the casino and somebody, like a Native American Indian, goes, "You're gonna do well today," and then they get all the money.
And then they walk into the woods.
Yeah. Okay. So all you want to open?
Yeah, open it up and
you guys direct us on the safety measures and all that, because apparently we can't use a hammer. So
no hammers.
No hammers.
We've never touched it. It hasn't been opened. So this little saran wrap that's on here is the original. No, you did.
No blood on it, right? There's no blood stains, nothing on it.
No, we know. We used it once, and it didn't even cut the flesh. To be honest with you.
Well, that's good. That's good.
It is heavy though.
Okay, I'll do this part, and then Steph will take out. Oh boy, it's like a volcano overflowing as we open it up. Can you see?
Yeah, I pointed it down.
Oh man. Oh, there's some. That guy was right. Yosemite Sam was right.
Man, you are just really unveiling it. Is that a skull?
There's a skull in there. Wait.
Oh, my. Right there, there's a little baby skull in there.
Oh, I see it. Silver?
I don't know.
We'll get to that.
Yeah.
I could probably suck it up through the top with this magnet.
Right? I bet you could.
Okay.
All right. Something fell out. Might as well look at that.
Is it a belt?
So right now, do you look right away? Like, I know before you guys have said like hallmarks, look for hallmarks and.
Well, I can tell this feels like it's definitely not good, but is this a belt?
Yes.
Let me feel.
I can't see it all the time.
It's lighter than it looks.
What else would it be?
It's a belt. It's from probably 80s.
And it's
Angie's looking here. I'll try it on.
It's lighter than it looks. Like looking at it, it
so
looks
funny.
Like
it's
actually cute. That is cute, actually.
It is cute.
It's a cute little belt.
It's adorable.
I'm wearing my bird shirt for Angie.
Can I use this now?
Okay, go for her.
I still knock her down.
Man.
It works.
Yeah, it's a sticker.
Okay.
I think it's nice.
Okay. This is kind of like all fadey. It's not like gold anymore.
Maybe it's.
Was it gold or was it silver? Oh, I see. It was gold tone and now it has patina. It has wear to the metal.
So is it garbage or what?
A dollar?
I wouldn't, if it was supposed to be gold tone and it has a lot of wear on it, I probably wouldn't sell it.
So Halloween costume, we'll take this to the swap meet and if somebody wants
it. What if we hit this with red paint? Just
red
this,
paint?
And
hit
take it? You know, just that part.
So somebody would have a gold belt on with a red leaf in the front?
All right, there's
Steph,
my.
Steph, it looked like it fits you pretty well. Why don't you just keep it?
It's cute.
All right. Maybe I'll find the right thing to wear it with.
All right.
Is it a belt?
Yeah, it's a belt. We decided. Okay, dump it.
Oh, you guys dump it out?
Yeah.
Oh.
It's a dump.
That's the fun part.
Oh, my goodness. Hold on.
Rip it out of there.
We got a giant gold bar that's making it stick in there.
Yay.
Those dog tags are.
All right, let me ask a question real quick. So, okay. Lonnie and Angie, you guys don't seem to be having a problem seeing exactly what they're doing at all times. My little screen here, the little square keeps going black, and I'm not able to always. I know.
Are you able to see them on the big screen, Tonya?
No, it doesn't come.
You can't see them at all?
It's just showing like our YouTube. I know. What am I going to do?
What do we do?
So if anybody. Log out, log in?
We'll pause. We still have this most of it in the jar. We'll pause if you want to log out and log in.
Well, how does that work if you're hosting, Lonnie?
Yeah, she's
I think it should be okay, but I'm not 100%.
What if she opens another, like invites herself and joins in another log, and then?
Oh, that's possible too.
Mutes the other one.
Like, who else am I going to log in as?
No, as yourself. Like, because I accidentally got in there when we were doing a football one with two people. I was in and two on one of my phone and one of my iPad.
Well, see, like right now I'm seeing you, but I don't see you on the big screen, but I see you down here on the little one on the panel.
Oh.
Okay, so if we look at can we look at this again and see if it's, it's going to still be small then.
Yeah, she needs to be able to see. She's helping us determine whether things are good or not.
Tonya, what browser are you using?
No, I was just thinking that, Lonnie. I'm in Safari. I'm thinking I should probably be in Google.
Go to open it in Chrome, and then get that going, and then there'll be another instance of Tonya, and then you close this one, just like Steph said.
Okay, I'm going to turn my camera and mic off, and I'm going to let you guys lead the show, and I'll be back in a minute.
Okay, yeah, okay. We'll be fine. We'll be fine.
Thank you.
We won't empty any more of this.
No,
if
but
you
we
find any gold, wait for me.
Yeah.
Okay.
No, we'll wait.
Surprisingly kind of cute stuff in here.
Hey. Okay. This would be good for pear picker, right?
Pear did, yeah.
Pear head picker.
Andy, yeah. Andy would love to wear that.
You think he would wear this?
No.
Probably on a hat.
If we sent it to him, it would be
Mrs. Parrot Head Picker would wear it. Maybe Desiree would.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Yeah, I think we should send that to him.
The tail's broken off.
Oh,
man. Yeah.
That's unfortunate.
Yeah.
Okay, so we'll put maybe good in this side of garbage back here. Or we can put garbage back in here when it's done.
I mean, even though this isn't perfect, this could be a nice gift for, like, friends.
Gift?
Yes. People, like, if you just give
Steve
it out.
Steve loves the idea of giving people gifts.
Here
that
you
are
go.
Like,
here's something broke. I love
it. It's tarnished and broken. You'll love it, right? And then they have
so much. Here's a broken thing.
That's a good question. Do y'all ever give like used stuff as gifts? I've never been able to do that, but I need to start because I have so much used stuff.
Okay, Steph and I have a different opinion on. Here's how I look at it. Like even this, okay? This right here. Let's say this is worth nothing, but we went out, we got this, and when we got this, we were excited. We invested a part of ourselves into the purchase of this.
Right.
So everything in here and this experience right now is a part of us that's going into it. And this, to me, the very first thing we did in our experiment with jewelry, this came out and my wife put it around her waist.
Are you about to sell this, Steve?
No, Lonnie, we want to get
it. I get it.
Lonnie, we want to gift this to you.
I don't want that.
There's people who like, and you might know people that they like certain things that are worthless, but they like it. So
yeah. Like this, I wouldn't say is just garbage because it actually still works.
It's
so
cute.
But we'll take it to the flea market and see if somebody wants it for 25 cents.
The only thing I can't see is how much wear is on it as far as if it was supposed to be gold and now it's mostly silver.
Yeah, I think even the back is silver though, and I don't know how the back would have got wear in those ridges.
Yeah. See, I wouldn't sell that in my shop, but yeah, it's fine to put at the swap meet. Yeah, somebody might want that for even a dollar.
You know what else we do at the swap meet?
Dollar's not bad.
We have stuff there that if like kids or teenagers, if they're there with their parents, and that's a common occurrence at our swap meets, and they're bored, they're on their phone or whatever, we give them stuff.
Yeah, they could go pick something out
of it.
That's nice.
Yeah. If somebody goes up and they look at this, we'll give it to them. Unless they hate it, unless we don't like them.
If they put their hand on it, they're going home with it.
Yeah, and they're thrilled.
I like what you said, though, about how you infuse items with your soul, almost. Yeah. That's a little exaggerated.
I feel that way. I know it sounds ridiculous, but I honestly feel that way. I feel like I find a way to love what we're selling. If it's customer returns, some things I am truly more passionate about. Like I do like finding old things, rare things, but I like to be, when I write something on an eBay listing or if I'm meeting somebody, I like to feel like, hey, I want you to have this because it's really good. It's great.
And I get that.
Yeah. So maybe this is just something some kid will walk by and look at, pick it up, and we'll say, hey, go ahead and keep that.
Yeah.
And then we'll ask for his address. Joking. Okay, okay, so Bonnie, are
let's
you?
Let's dump.
Okay, we're talking
Tonya, back. Are you good? Are you good?
I'm good. I'm so Tonya's happy. Back. This is such a great idea. Oh, thank
great,
you.
Tonya.
Okay, Tonya.
I don't know how to get.
We're going to be dumping
oh, there.
It out.
Even better.
Okay, am I dumping it?
Yeah.
Wow, that's a lot of stuff in that jar.
It is.
It's a big jar. Oh.
They jammed it full. It gets wedged up in here. Oh, man.
It looks like pretty good stuff.
Bracelet Palooza. Uh-oh, something fell.
Not total behind garbage.
You. Behind you.
Okay.
Oh, pearls.
Oh, my gosh, there's a knife.
Oh, is it
ooh.
One of the...
Oh, I have one just like that.
Not even
I carry it in my purse.
This fell. Oh, a rare coin fell out.
A penny? Oh, well, we're a penny less. We're in the positive here okay. On this one so far. Okay.
All right,
let's
Steph.
Go. So, let's see. You want to pick it? Something? No.
No, you do it.
Okay.
I dumped it.
Well, this stood out to me first.
I can
but
see
the tag
why.
On it says $2.99 and nobody bought it.
That was a Savers tag.
Oh, so, that's a neat thing. I love that.
You like this?
Oh, I see a hang tag on it too.
I know it was only $2.99. So, and no one bought it at $2.99. How do I get it out? Okay, here.
I don't think at our Savers, it doesn't look like there's a lot of people in the jury section over there. Whenever we're in there.
This looks big too. Is this a belt?
What is Angie, what is that? Is that called like enamel or something? That
yes. Very good, Molly.
Yeah.
It looks
very
like
good.
Someone took nail polish and poured it in there.
That is like metallic swirly enamel. I'd say like
breaking,
nail polish maybe or rainbow colors.
Okay. Well,
is it a choker necklace maybe?
It looks like it's going to be pretty long.
Well, tell them that, Angie. Wrong people to say choker.
Yeah, choker necklace.
I take that back.
Hey, do you guys think we ought to be locked on StevenSteph so when we talk it doesn't move the camera? Do you think?
Well, right think? Now, we're about this to thing, break a piece of jewelry. Here, let me
break it.
Part off real quick.
The thing is.
So, this is, I mean, there's...
We do want to see it. Here, yeah. Well, Steph's going to try to gently undo that.
Here, I got it.
Oh, good job.
Okay.
It's very...
That's awesome. I love that piece.
Really?
I do, too. I actually is like it, the colors on there, Angie. To me, they are very... it's like acid stain on concrete. You could color concrete. It reminds me of that. It's got like a variegated... Look
you,
on those colors.
You may not know this, but Steve comes from construction background where we're a concrete company. And so yeah. Steve sees everything as a concrete possibility.
Okay. Right.
In my yeah. shop, that would probably be at least, I don't know, maybe 30.
What? We
what? What would you put on Tonya?
Well, wait, first of all, is it signed? Do you see a name on it?
Yeah, is it signed?
And hey guys, just so y'all know, whenever I first heard of signed, I thought they meant like signed.
Sign language?
Oh.
But it says, really just means a Hallmark stamp or something on it.
It says to Fanny. No, I'm joking.
To Fanny.
Okay, I'm taking the $2.99 off. I don't see any signature.
I think it's $30.
It doesn't feel like it's really like amazing quality, but it is heavy.
To me, Steph and I, we see these things differently. And they feel differently. Like to me, especially comparing it to this first one, it feels, it's got a thickness to it and it's more weighty. It's not, Okay,
that's a good idea.
Oh, that is awesome.
And it, I like it a lot.
I love that. For this.
Why am I doing that? No.
Oh, you are rocking that well, Steve.
You know what? It's heavy.
Let's get a little chest hair first. Here we go.
Oh,
there you are.
Okay,
that
so
that looks like a metro sexual thing.
Where are you in the picture?
Not.
All right, I'm gonna be speechless here in a second. I like it a lot, and so you're
say 30 on this.
30.
That's like our whole jar, more than
I have to look at comps.
We're not gonna hold you to that, Angie. We'll expect at least 28 to 30.
Okay,
I like it.
Tonya.
A signature would be here, right? On the little claspy part, probably? Or behind it?
Yeah, around that
one
area.
One of the main pieces, though, right?
Yeah, I would set that one aside to sell separately for sure.
How would you describe, I guess we could ask that later, like if we were going to sell it, what do you call this? Like,
You want to go, Angie, or you want me to?
No, I've talked enough. I haven't even left you talk. You talk.
Hey, can I name it first? I name it first?
Yes. Yeah, name it.
Yeah, name it.
I would call that a rainbow, colorful enamel necklace thing.
That's what I would call it, too.
That's an excellent suggestion, Tanya.
I would definitely say gold tone, Trifari enamel, red, blue.
Wait, Trifari isn't a brand?
Trifari is. I thought you said it was Mark Trifari.
No, that is
no Mark.
Oh, it's not Mark.
Look, Julie, let me read this in the chat, guys. Let me read this in the chat.
Oh,
Julie,
he said wait, Tiffany is what he said.
Julie Venerum says gold tone segmented. I like that word.
Yeah.
Gold tone segmented jewel tone enamel. Okay. That sounds good, Julie. I like that.
Julie is good with her keywords. She's a good
segmented.
So are you, Andy.
Thank you.
Sorry, Tanya. I was making a joke about Tiffany. Like Tiffany.
Okay.
Oh.
I'm the only one that got it.
Let's try your menu.
I have a question.
Gold.
Ooh.
Yes, ma'am.
If it's gold, we're shutting down and running to the pawn shop right now. Okay.
It's not gold, I can tell you that.
Yeah.
Hey, you want to see how far I can make this thing fly?
Oh, my gosh. That's dangerous.
We might damage it.
Yeah, that's dangerous.
I could fly that thing halfway across. Wait, don't move. You stay there. Okay. Watch it. Watch.
Oh. Ooh.
Oh, wow.
Good one.
Anyways.
Okay, so that's a maybe.
Okay, so Angie, what was your question, Angie?
I was going to say, in your Etsy shop, what would your ballpark be for that necklace before you even knew that I said what I said?
Everything changes now that I know that it's not Trifari. So I would shoot for anywhere between maybe $16.99,
$19.99.
What do you think?
Okay.
A lot of people in the chat that went a lot lower. Now, I don't know if they're eBay people or, you know, because people and my Etsy customers are willing to pay more, you know, for things like that. I found in my, you know, my 7 years in Etsy that I think I have a certain customer base that look for that kind of thing.
Yeah.
So I might not be quite as high as that, but, you know, I'd look at the comps.
Yeah, course, definitely.
It's hard to look at the comps for Etsy, but.
Yeah, you know, and I think that you would know better than anybody, too.
And if we don't.
I'm not saying that at all.
What is it, Tanya, if we don't price it high?
Yeah, if you don't ask for a lot of money, you can't make a lot of money.
That's right.
We can start with Angie price and then lower it down. But
that's
how can
true.
We know,
you can always put it up and lower it down.
Like on this, you'd be confident enough that this was vintage for Etsy, okay?
Yeah.
Nice.
I don't know how you'd even know that.
You picked one that you thought was nice.
I just thought it was kind of cool. But here's something for Lonnie. We could get to that later.
Okay.
Yeah, eBay 18. Let's get.
Okay, you pick. Your turn.
I get to pick.
By the way, there's a few watches in here that.
Okay, I'm going. Watches. I'm picking this out because it says rad.
Oh, that's cool.
Cool.
Yeah.
That's somebody's wishes, though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, but like, still, dude, somebody would love that just for rad.
That is really neat.
It's kind of bedazzled. So. How do I tell if those are real pearls? Whatever it is.
It's not.
I know. It's just a,
that's really pretty, though.
I might be pulling some.
It's missing a pearl.
I could see a hipster buying that because it's ironic. You
it's
know?
Not.
Definitely.
Uh-oh. Only the little end is. We got some gold, people. So that's just like a little, this would probably be a gift.
Aluminum or something?
A giveaway. You know, at our swap meet or something, maybe.
Well, there's all kind of stuff that's not magnetic, like brass, brass and bronze. Bronze is not magnetic, is it?
I'm not sure.
So unless somebody, this would be something that if, you know, if we go to the swap meet and the kid or anybody looks at it, we're going to say, you can have it.
Right.
Yeah.
Spreading good cheer, and it's rad.
Or we could put, like Tanya said, she will make a jewelry jar to sell it. Right?
Yeah, that's a really good idea, definitely. As a matter of fact, whenever I'm doing a jewelry jar, I've got separate little like bins, if you will, because I don't want to have to go through it again after I've already gone through it once. So I'll empty out the jar and I'll keep the jar there, and whatever I don't want to keep, whatever I'm going to resell or put in another jewelry jar, I'll put back in the jar.
Okay, so we have two questions real quick, guys.
Sure.
two questions in the chat. Ohio Homegirl has a question.
Oh, homegirl.
Is that how you do it? Oh, homegirl. Is the steampunk jewelry still popular?
Ooh.
Oh.
Yeah, I think there's definitely a market for that. Nice. And always will be. It's really popular, I feel like.
I think it's going to be something that there will always be a market for it as long as somebody likes it, you know?
Definitely.
And there will always be people that like it, so.
Yeah.
Okay, and then real quick, guys, Neville has a question. Can you sell newer jewelry on Etsy?
No. Anything that you sell on Etsy has to be 1998 and before, right, Angie?
Yeah. Or handmade by you, right?
Yeah, or handmade.
Or also supplies like.
Which is crazy because when I think of vintage, I think of like, well, for me, it used to be like the 70s, but now I guess really the 80s, and I feel like 80s are kind of like retro.
Well, here's a good point, okay? Bargain Shopping in the chat says, people sell lots of broken jewelry for crafts, so you could sell those like that. So that rad thing, even if it was made last year, qualifies because it's missing a little stone, and you can just sell it as supplies, right? Is that correct?
On Etsy?
Yeah.
That's a good point that you bring up.
I know. That's a really good point. I didn't make it. That was Bargain Shopping made that point.
Crafting jar.
Good suggestion.
That's a great idea.
I think when we were talking about mystery boxes, that point came up about you could do them in Etsy as a craft item.
Yeah, definitely. Because I craft with jewelry. As a matter of fact, I've got a whole big jar that I, you know, whenever I'm doing the jewelry jars, I'll also put stuff in my crafting jar too that I'm just going to, you know, set aside for whenever I get ready to craft and make something.
Okay, here's a question.
You're very organized.
What exactly would be a craft you'd make with it other than another piece of jewelry?
Piece of art.
Go check out my videos, y'all.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, all kinds of things. Yeah.
Yeah, you could bedazzle some rocks or anything. Your imagination go.
Okay, let me interrupt one more quick question. This is keeping it real with the Millers. How to know what items to sell on eBay versus Etsy?
Well, the first thing you have to consider is it old enough? And Etsy is I think it's a more like. When I think of Etsy, I think of either like unique items. This is just my mindset on Etsy. I think unique items, vintage items that people might not see other places, boutique type items you'd see in a little shop in Martha's Vineyard, you know, just things that are kind of special. Not your everyday run-of-the-mill items.
Right. And also, like, the necklace that I'm wearing, you know, you can definitely tell this is, like, a newer piece. And Bonnie had brought up before also to look at the clasp, like on the necklaces. For example, a lot of the ones that have the spring hinge will probably be older, say, compared to, like, the ones that have the, what do you call it, like a lobster clasp, Angie?
Yeah.
Those will a lot of times maybe, like, the newer ones.
Okay.
Can we show our jewelry while we're talking about that, Tonya?
Yes. Go ahead, Angie.
Go ahead.
Yeah.
Okay. So, Tonya and I are gonna like showcase pieces of our jewelry that are in our shop during these shows. It was Tonya's idea, so you know, it's a good way to, you know, bring attention to our shop. So, you know, my shop is dazzled by vintage, and I have this necklace.
I love it, Angie. Nice.
And it is Canateel. This is actually a sterling. Don't look at any chin hairs or anything.
Dragonfly.
Is Canateel a brand?
No, it is a type of spun silver filigree work.
Okay.
And I keep going the wrong way.
Nice.
It looks good. I can see it.
Okay, that is sterling silver. However, the chain is not. It's not original to the chain. So that is in my shop. It looks, I think it's really cute.
It kind of looks like it's flying on there. It kind of flops around.
Yeah. Well, I have a wardrobe mount.
Malfunction.
And then there's this. Oh, come here. Where are you?
Ooh.
Very, come here. Very beautiful ring.
Yeah, I love that. Very elegant.
And it fits me. I just realized that. And now I'm having a hard time maybe putting it back in my inventory because it's really pretty.
Well, so, are those real diamonds on there?
No.
No, there are cubic zirconia.
Is that called a cocktail ring, Angie?
Listen to Lonnie go. Yes, that
would. How did you know, Lonnie?
I've heard of it before. I listen to people and remember things.
These are simulated. How do you know by looking at it that no, that's not diamonds?
Because she's selling it in her shop.
Right.
I mean.
Yeah. Right. I couldn't afford to buy it and sell it in my shop if it was diamonds. I don't have that kind of money. But it's simulated stones, all simulated stones, okay. And it's kind of a dusty rose color. The stones are actually. Great. I can't get my hand right.
It's really unique.
It's really pretty.
Thank you very much. So, Tonya, look at yours.
My piece. No,
are y'all selling this stuff, guys? Like, are y'all going to sell this stuff today?
It's already on there.
It's in our shop.
Yeah. Mine will be shortly.
So are the links down below?
Well, that's a good point. Thanks, Lonnie. I'll have to go back and add our shops for sure.
Okay, cool. I'm sorry. Go ahead, Tonya.
Okay, so my piece is just really simple. It will not be going in my Etsy shop because it's newer. So if you'd like to buy this piece, it will be in my eBay store. And I have to show my ring. I'm rocking this ring, you guys, I got for $5.99, but it's my size and I'm keeping it.
Oh,
nice.
Okay, back to our guest. And we got to hurry up. We've only been through two items, you guys. It's already 11:34.
I thought this was kind of cute.
Yeah.
Oh, I like that a lot.
Is it garbage or is it? It'd be up here. But they wouldn't make a silver thing no matter what up here, right?
Why not?
Well, this is weird. Look, it's got, I don't know if you could see it, it has two clasps. Why would it ever have that?
Shorten it up for somebody?
Or did somebody else put a little extension chain on there? So they
somebody might have put an extension chain on there, I would think. What do you think?
Okay. Yeah.
Somebody with a big neck.
She wanted it a little bit lower with her outfit. She knew.
That's nice.
Yeah.
Oh, that matches.
Yeah, that looks good with what you have on now.
Oh.
It's got a tropical feel to it.
Yeah, you need to keep that on.
It feels like Bakelite.
Yeah, that's that piece of chain is probably an extender chain. Could very well have been meant to, it could very well have been on there and was purchased on there with the necklace.
Okay, I'll leave it. It doesn't match, though. Like, the chains are different size.
All the chains. Well, still
could be?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll leave it on there. Or maybe I'll keep it. If I ever start wearing jewelry, then maybe I'll.
Yeah, they come in handy. They come in
handy. Yeah, I love it.
Oh, yeah, she'd wear it. But with this would be non. It looks 80s to me. So Etsy or no?
Yeah, that's a newer piece, definitely.
Newer?
Yeah, but.
Yeah.
Yeah. Bonnie in the chat says it's plastic and modern.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Lobster class.
So like $1.99.
So flea market.
So
Angie, let me ask you.
What?
I was just gonna say real quick, Angie, I noticed that Bonnie says it's plastic and modern - lobster clasp. Is a lobster clasp indicative of being a modern piece? They didn't used to make those? Okay.
Yes.
I'm sorry, Tonya.
That's okay. I was just going to say that would be a piece I might put in my antique booth for, you know, maybe $9.99.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Somebody buy that. It's almost kind of like nautical themed, right? With the color, it looked really good, like with the, you know.
Somebody in Florida or something would love this.
Yeah.
Hey, there's people wear brooches. Remember that whole subject?
Yeah.
We have a friend that all of a sudden we realize, oh, they wear brooches all the time. Okay, I think
Bonnie says that the lobster claw clasps are from the 90s, probably originated in the 90s. So they are, that would be old enough actually for Etsy.
Okay. That so what would happen? Would they just, someone would report you and say, hey, this person's a liar?
Yeah, I have had a piece taken down from Etsy because I didn't realize it was new. newer.
Is there a penalty, like eBay has, or what happens?
Well, if you continually do it, they might close your store.
But okay.
I actually put a piece of Leah Sophia jewelry up, and that is like a brand that has parties, but I didn't realize that their company didn't get started till I think 2001, and I didn't. My fault. I didn't do my research, and they took the piece down and warned me that.
Okay. What was the company, Angie?
Leah Sophia.
Yeah, you know what? I see that stuff all the time, and I don't even buy it because it's like a dime a dozen, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So that was my lesson, and I really try now not to put anything up that's not old enough. But, you know, sometimes you just have to guess.
Okay.
Yeah. You don't have any recourse but to guess. You can't find the company, but, you know, you try your best.
Okay. What do you got, honey?
I've got something that I really like.
Wait, we need two of those.
Well, there might be another one, but you could wear this by itself. Okay, first off, see it swimming? It's swimming.
Oh, I love it.
That is cute.
Yeah, he's got, that's plaid, right? Like his
checkerboard.
Yeah,
gingham. Or her outfit. And then there's a diamond.
Can you... Keep it a little bit further away from the...
Oh, okay.
It's an earring.
It's an earring.
Oh, that's awesome.
It is?
Wow, yeah. Here, like, look at the eye, and then behind the neck area, I think it's wearing a little necklace or something.
I think so, too.
That's very cute.
Do you have both of the earrings?
Probably.
Well, this was owned by somebody with one ear, so...
Yeah, you chopped the other one off. That's what happened.
All right.
It really, like, I'm not, you know, I don't wear jewelry or anything, but when I saw this down there, it actually caught my eye, and I think it's neat.
That's called a Van Gogh style.
Yeah, it's got eyelash Van Gogh.
It's really weird. I can't imagine somebody wearing this. It's so weird.
This is the Van Gogh. Thanks, Lauren. So, but it's got a little red dot. Little details on this are cool.
Yeah, Julie Venera brings up a good point. She says it could be Betsy Johnson. That totally looks like a Betsy Johnson piece.
Yeah.
Oh.
Okay.
So,
and hope you have the other one.
Yeah.
It really is neat, though, huh?
It is neat. You. There's so much.
Richard Hustler says Mike Tyson victim.
Vander Holyfield's earring.
That's funny. Okay, I've got something that is very weird to me, but I don't know if I should put it on my man hand here. But look, it's a ring.
It's kind of gaudy chic.
Wow, that's neat.
Oh my goodness!
Right, and what's that called, Lonnie?
Look at the bulky ring part. That's neat.
Cocktail ring, right?
Oh, is it? Okay.
So it's springy.
Stretch ring.
And it has a little diamond or big diamond inside, which I hope is real, but I doubt they put diamond with plastic.
I would also call that like a statement ring too. Mm-hmm.
But this looks vintage to me.
No.
I like the statement ring.
It just looks so, is it because you can tell by the little plasticky thingies or why? How do you know this is not? Like what would your gut?
Those type of rings just kind of came into popularity within the past few years. You see them around all the time in the stores.
Oh,
I don't know. Just the look of it. Just
pretty simple.
What do you think?
Bonnie says not vintage. Yeah. Sorry.
Okay, thank you.
I agree with Angie.
Okay.
But at a flea market, like
it's neat.
$40?
Yeah.
Maybe. Gabby chic. I might need the loop because I've got a mark on this item.
Ooh, the loop.
Oh, hey.
Oh,
there's a mark.
Yes. I don't want them to see it yet because I want to dazzle them.
Hey, do you think if you held your loop up to your camera, like right on it, and then brought the jewelry in, would that work?
Has anybody tried
that before?
We'll try it, but we want to see you're going to have to look.
I've got better eyes.
Don't let them see the thing.
The price tag?
No, I don't want them to see what it is.
Oh.
I like to do the unveiling. It's fun for me.
So you're blocking my... Oh, it says Avon.
No. Why do you say it? It's got a mark on it. It says Avon.
All right.
So anyway.
The French.
Yeah, it's Avon. I don't know how to do this, guys, but give me some... Can you see that? It's just Avon ring.
That's pretty.
And it actually, this caught my eye too. So I don't know why I think Avon might not be that good, but. So
yeah,
let's,
I guess that doesn't work with
apparently we'll move right along, but I'm going to set the Avon in the good side.
Yeah, I feel like you could probably sell that in your at your swap meet for like, you know, maybe 10 bucks.
No.
What?
I would put a $10 tag on it in my antique booth. $10, I mean, it looks like a real gold
ring. At a swap meet, it might be a little less though, huh?
We're going to try to sell some of it locally just to experiment with this genre.
Oh, you're going to put it in your trunk and upsell like you want a blender and a ring?
Okay, would anyone ever sell real gold?
I don't think so. Did they?
It's not magnetic.
They're saying that you're holding it too close. They can't see in the chat.
You want to put this behind it or?
Here. Actually, I have a ring thing. I didn't bother grabbing it though. But okay, it's not beautiful. Here, we'll talk about these real quick while I try to find the little ring thing.
They're cool.
Yeah, I like those.
These are clip-ons. So I thought maybe they're
probably, they might be vintage.
Yeah, definitely.
Maybe they're vintage. Probably maybe 80s.
Is this the ring thing?
They're neat.
Really? I was going to say 60s, but yeah.
It could be. I don't know. What's Bonnie think? Bonnie, in the chat.
I don't know where the ring thing is.
What year do you think they're?
Could we see the back of them?
Maybe 70s.
Yeah, I can.
Okay, I'll open one of them so you can see the back. It looks just like my grandma's clip-ons. It's a little
Yep.
Oh, they might be. Yeah, they might be 60s, 70s.
Cool. Yeah. Let me see if there's a mark, actually. I never thought
to look. Would see the back.
Would something like a costume jewelry even have a mark from back then?
Some of them would. Yeah, depending.
Those are neat also.
Yeah. Because you have the earrings.
Apparently, I like the flashy.
Oh, that's
slinger.
Oh, hey.
Why am I being paraded around?
There you go, honey.
Tribal.
You guys should sell those on Etsy and let Steve be the model for the pictures.
No, I think
that you would get a lot of attention that way.
I agree.
I don't want that.
No one could judge us, you know.
Okay, this is the Avon ring. And tell me when to go back or
maybe don't spin it.
Put this behind it.
It looks like a buckle.
Yeah,
it's a buckle with little diamonds in it.
Go back a little. It's not focusing real. Stop. I'm talking to you like I'm talking to my husband.
Fine.
Perfect. We need it.
Bossing him around.
I'm trying to dig for something.
I don't know if that helps any.
Yeah, you just can't see it too well, unfortunately.
Is there anything else I can? Well, maybe because the number part was there.
Well, at least we have a thumbnail for this video now, Steve.
Hey,
yeah.
Don't do that.
Okay, for these, while you're thinking about this, for these 70s,
now it's work. And now it's work.
Like on Etsy.
Yeah.
You guys have to. Lonnie, are you reading the chat?
I am, but I.
Etsy, what would
I
you do?
I got
for
a
me?
Few things written down here. So.
Oh, good.
Start them out. Like 10 bucks or what?
I would say at least 15. What do you think?
Really?
Man, we're making money on this lot.
Yeah, I would definitely go with that number.
Wow.
15 sounds good.
Fun.
Did anybody say anything
the
about?
They're 60s to 80s, Bonnie.
Okay, let me.
We trust Bonnie's opinion. She's really the expert.
Thanks, Bonnie.
He's very knowledgeable.
Does Bonnie have a channel?
No, but she has a Facebook group.
Okay.
Story Junkies Corner?
Oh, I'm in it.
She helps us out a lot, and she's our go-to whenever we need help ourselves. So,
yes.
Bonnie?
Very smart.
And Hedwig David is also very knowledgeable. She's in the chat. And Vicki is in the chat. She's very knowledgeable. So we have a lot of people in there that
can help.
Okay, so Homegirl says Avon is decent quality costume jewelry. They have sterling silver jewelry also. People would buy that at the flea market. A Purple Lily said sometimes Avon will sell real jewelry, but it will be marked. So
I never knew that.
I didn't look for another mark.
It's not magnetic.
Julie says some people still collect Avon. Few rare Avon pieces can be precious metal. So it's not likely, but it sounds like it happens.
Something to check out.
So there's no way these would be real little diamonds in there.
It's a belt buckle. It looks like a belt with a horseshoe shape on it.
Okay.
Avon typically is just not desirable.
Okay, no. this I think is ugly.
Let me see.
But maybe not. But I have a question about pearls. Like, there's stuff stuck in it.
That looks like a 50s, 60s piece.
Possibly. Yeah.
Not
just
ugly?
You can tell by the way the charm bracelet looks.
50s or 60s?
Possibly.
That's cool.
That doesn't mean it's real valuable, though, right?
Let's see the clasp.
There's no clasp. It's springy.
Oh, it's stretchy, then no. It's probably not.
Let's see it up close. Yeah, I don't know.
Oh, wait, hold on.
Are there markings on the thing?
Oh, that's a good idea.
Are there markings on the ball things?
I don't know. Okay. Honestly, I would have thought that was vintage, but I'm not definitely not an expert.
Okay, well, my question was about the whole pearl thing. If you rub it on your tooth, you're supposed to feel something, right? That's how you know real quick.
Don't rub that on your tooth.
It's true.
Rub it on Jerry's tooth.
Oh, my gosh.
What's the rule?
I got a rule. Don't rub the stuff that's been handled by everybody at Savers on your tooth.
Yeah. that's a good rule.
Well, what do I do? Run it through the dishwasher and then stick it on my teeth?
You know, just put some alcohol on it first, maybe.
Oh.
Then you can put it on your teeth.
But I meant for people like out at things. What's the rule with the pearls? Do you even remember? Anybody know it? It's
I don't care.
Like something on your tooth, if it's real.
I don't know one. Other than just to look at the quality of the piece. And if the piece is, you know, sterling or gold, then there's a good chance that it's a real pearl. But
Bonnie says real pearls are gritty, faux pearls are totally smooth. I don't know if she's talking about that's what it feels like when you rub it on your teeth or what.
That's not smooth on my tooth. I did read something about it tasted good too.
We go to the doctors after this.
But it was smooth. I figured these were fake. I just wanted to bring it up because of the thing. Oh, so on this little piece, this would be a flea market little find?
$5.
Yeah, probably. What do you think, Angie?
Yes, $5.
Okay. Tammy talks in the chat, makes a good point. First, see if there's a line on the stone, then you know it isn't a pearl.
Oh,
you know,
that is a good
point. It would just be
point.
Like a bead, you know?
No line. But it doesn't look real.
Okay, I found something that has a mark, which I cannot read, but.
Okay.
It's a brooch.
Mm-hmm. Here, stick it on the end of this.
Oh, it's not magnetic.
Oh.
It's not magnetic.
Uh-oh.
Mm-hmm.
And Steph's going to read the mark.
I'm getting an echo, guys.
I'm hearing
anybody
it.
Anybody else hear?
Here's Steph.
I don't hear
Steph's
it.
Steph's gonna read it. You need the loop.
It's something K. Something K.
What?
But it looks like 80K. I don't know. Let me see.
80K.
Oh.
8K?
It's a something K?
There's a K.
Is there like a circle and then a...
But it could be somebody's mark is something that ends in a K, right? Because I definitely see a C, a gold. Like, you know, the little trademark thing, the trademark copyright? It looks like a copyright. The C with the
guys, we got a bad echo here, I think. Y'all not hear this echo?
Yeah, I hear it.
Somebody.
We're hearing Nitmeco also.
Okay.
Be careful.
We're getting feedback from somebody.
I just heard Lonnie do it.
I don't hear any echo at all.
Okay, didn't hear it from.
Should I talk and see if there's any echo with me?
Yes, there
Let's
is.
Let's each take a turn and mute.
I think it's on your side, StevenSteph.
What could it be? We've nothing open.
We don't hear Tonya echo, but we hear Angie. We hear Angie and Lonnie.
Okay, let's mute. If we mute, we'll know it's us.
Okay, are y'all muted now? I still hear the echo.
Not us.
Angie, why don't you mute for a second?
Okay.
Are you muted?
We still got echo? Dang, we still got
echo. Hello.
All right, I'm going to mute.
Is it me?
Tonya.
Okay. Hello, hello.
Lonnie's up.
Lonnie.
It's Tonya then, maybe.
Okay, I was muted.
Tonya.
Really? What am I going to do? I already got earbuds on.
We don't know for sure. We need you to mute.
I'm muted.
Okay. All right, let me try.
Are you muted?
Yeah, she's muted.
It's Tonya.
She's muted.
It's Tonya.
Aww.
I don't know how.
Is somebody watching it in her house somewhere else?
I don't hear the echo now. It's crazy. I don't know. Now it's back. Yeah, it's back now.
Okay, let me just take it.
Is there writing this other way also? Like, see this?
Am I still echoing, Bonnie?
Where? Chipped
off. I don't hear the echo now.
No, I don't hear it now.
Okay, I took out my earbuds. Okay.
It was feeding back through. It was feeding back from your headphone to your microphone right there.
Oh my goodness.
Somehow.
Okay, so this one, you want to try to loop up against the camera and see if that works?
I think it's gold plated or something, maybe, because there's a little part where the goldy part's chipped off on the...
Let's try to show them with the loop.
Oh.
Let's try the loop. I'll hold that, and then you make the adjustment.
Oh, wow, that's coming in nice and clear.
Yeah.
That's the loop, Lonnie. Good idea.
It looks gold plated to me. It's not the right color for gold.
Yep. It's not real heavy either, so.
Yeah.
But it does have a K at the end.
Oh, yeah, it's definitely BSK. Yeah.
Oh, BSK.
It's costume jewelry.
Okay.
BSK is a 1960s designer.
What?
Yeah.
Yeah, Bonnie says it's costume. Don't get excited.
Is there value to it? Is this on the market?
People collect BSK jewelry. So yeah, I would. That's a keeper.
Okay. And every single item has had some value. This is weird, and the pile is huge.
It's just costume, though. Don't start twerking or anything, Steve.
So you guys, it's 11:55. So you might want to pick out maybe one or two more pieces that you really, really like, because I can't let this go no longer than 12:15. I got to take my kids somewhere.
Okay. Ooh. Go ahead. You grab one too.
Okay. I'll do.
Okay. You ready? Bum, 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 bum.
Oh, that's pretty.
That is pretty.
Back a little bit.
They win.
Okay. I don't know. It's still real. Maybe it's me. Okay.
Probably me, but you want to see the back?
Yes.
Had little flowers on there.
Not signed, huh?
Let me look. No, there's nothing, but it's kind of, you know, just, I would say elaborate, but I don't know what.
Mm-hmm.
I'm learning a new language in the jury.
It's filigree.
What filigree.
It's adorable.
Yeah.
I like that. Filigree. So something like this, just like a couple dollar.
Yeah, I don't know.
There's no markings or anything.
Are there plastic flowers on it, or what's on it?
Yeah, they're the middle.
Those are fake little beads. Or pearls.
Is it plastic?
Yeah, it's plastic.
It feels like plastic. Green.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Yeah. Dollar. Whatever.
Yeah.
It doesn't. Yeah.
A gift. A gift to somebody that looks at our stuff.
All right. Yeah. So this is an incline little. Just the watch face and the watch band's gone. Is this pretty much garbage or worth doing anything with? Something like this?
I put that in a steampunk lot.
You what?
Like a steampunk lot?
Yeah.
Just leave it in there? Just put a little pile of steampunk stuff and a watch face?
Or I guess it could be in your basket at your swap meet.
Okay, give it to a little girl for something.
Yep.
Okay, we haven't even touched the surface on this.
Ooh, look, Vader.
Is that a cat?
That's Vader. That's Darth Vader.
Darth Vader. We're just showing Lonnie.
I am your father.
Oh, here's I think was the skull. It looks like a little, I think it's a rabbit.
Oh, that's cute.
A little diamondy rabbit thing.
Oh, yeah, that's cute.
He's
Is that signed anywhere? That's a nice piece.
Would it be?
if there's nothing missing.
That's really neat. That's really neat. I like that.
There's no stones missing.
No, I don't see any stones missing, but it, I don't see a signature, but I'm not even positive I would know that it was one. I don't see anything on there. It's cute, though.
Yeah, it's a black.
Yeah, that I would put on a chain and sell it like that. I wouldn't sell it just as a separate pendant. Tonya, I find I do better putting my pendants on a chain.
Okay.
What do you think, Tonya?
Yeah, I mean, if you're going to sell them that way, like, you mean if you're going to put it in your shop or something?
Yeah. If I was going to put that in my shop, I'd find a chain to put it on.
Yeah, I think it's a great idea.
I feel that.
I don't know if it's a little Lego knife or what, but there's a knife in here.
Oh, that's cool.
You guys got to keep that.
That's perfect for y'all.
Yes, that's you. So totally you.
What is it doing in there?
They knew you were going to buy this jar.
Right. That jar was meant for y'all.
Yeah, I guess so. All right, here we go. Ready? This feels like real pearl. Totally different from the other one. Are you going to put it on your teeth?
It was gritty on your teeth stuff?
It was. This one was
right. Look at the clasp. Are there any kind of markings on it?
It's broken. The clasp part's off.
Oh.
But is there a value in the pearl? I guess in a crafting lot it would be, maybe.
Put the magnet on that clasp.
Where'd that magnet go? Oh, the magnet. Oh. Nothing.
Okay, that needs tested. That could be gold.
Just this little piece, would it be? I mean, it's such a small little piece. Would that be worth it just to send it in?
Every little bit counts.
Does the clasp stick to a magnet?
Oh, and there's real. I remember hearing my grandma said this about this, but with pearls, if they're real knots in between with the things,
right?
These have real knots, and some of them are misshapen a little teeny bit.
Yeah, you need to investigate that. Yeah,
what do you mean by investigate? We need to know what that means.
Test it, honey.
Like, I investigate this.
Like, if those pearls are gritty and that gold looks real, I just run it by a jeweler and just take it in there and say, can you verify if this is real pearls and if this is gold, please?
Test the gold real fast, guys. It only takes like a second.
Okay. How would I even know what number to test?
First of all, does it stick to a magnet?
No,
it doesn't.
Okay.
Hey, Steve, would you hold that little knife up real quick? I want to see that again.
It's lost.
It's a cute butterfly.
Oh.
It is neat. It's a little
neat. Tonya, butterfly.
I mean, this one?
Is it a pin?
Kidding.
Not that knife.
It's a ring.
Oh, it's a cute little knife. I didn't get you.
Funny, Lonnie.
There we go.
People collect miniatures, Vicki Olson says. So that even has value.
Yeah, that's a great point.
That goes with that RIP.
Yes.
Yes, it does.
Okay.
Now, this was just
for the show. Here's my little block.
Where's your gloves? Where's your gloves? I got so much.
Yeah, you don't want to be all yellow fingers.
Hold on.
I still have yellow on my fingers.
Get it. Okay.
Tonya, are we going to run out of time? Are you okay, Tonya?
Oh, my God. This is a big finish, Tonya. You got to let them test it.
Yes. Okay. Let's let them test it, and then we'll talk about it.
I don't know how to make much more of a streak than that. Is that enough?
That's a good streak, yeah.
It's good.
Okay. Go. That's a lot.
It's a lot? Oh, sorry. I just lost a lot of value.
You just lost a gram of gold.
I'm pretty sure this is going to be real. I'm almost positive.
I'm thinking, too.
Okay. What are you going to test it with? 10K first, right?
Yeah, Lonnie did that when he did that test.
10K. These have kind of got, I think one of them leaked out. So 10K is this one.
Oh, this is so good.
My heart's beating fast.
What are these?
Oh, look at the bug. Stab that bug with the little knife.
Silver? Oh, we have two 10Ks in here. Okay. So
lock it to them, Tonya. Lock the screen to them.
Okay.
Oh, I've never even opened it.
Here, we're locked in the deal. You can do it with the gloves.
I got gloves.
Here, let me turn to tell me when it's going to want to run. Can you guys see it?
Yeah, we can see it good.
So what are we supposed to do?
If it doesn't disappear, that means it's real.
Okay, so now we wipe it off.
No way.
It didn't disappear.
Do the drums again.
Then that means it's real.
But
money.
Yeah. Well, no, I don't even know what that means.
It's
like,
real.
It's real just gold. A real little teeny piece of gold, but
if the acid doesn't eat it up, then it's real.
Yeah,
but
so
it's
that
real
means
10 carats.
That means the pearls are probably real too, right?
Yeah,
I would say. I think those pearls are real for sure. They look all kind of weirdish. why is it? Hold on a minute. Are we talking like 50 cents?
Twerk,
gold?
Steve, you twerk, yeah. Twerk.
Twerk and see that. Come on.
I'm confused. I don't know anything.
This is a home run.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, I love this show.
Okay, explain, please. Like, if it's 10 karat gold, that's really pure gold, right? Or no?
Bonnie says you need to rub the acid over the mark. Don't just let it sit on the mark.
Rub it with your gloves. Should I get a paper towel and dry it off?
I rubbed it. It's still there, but
do I need a napkin?
I think I rubbed it too hard and I just whooshed it off. But I can see that it's still sitting over here. If that makes sense.
Put that up here so we can see it.
I think I rubbed too hard on the thing with my finger.
Do you want to, is it gone or is it not gone? Am I twerking for no reason?
Well, I can see all the flakes all along that I moved. Remember, I mushed it too hard, I think.
But
I can do another streak.
Should it stay there if she rubbed it or?
It will fade if it's not gold.
Yeah.
What do you mean by fade? Like, I feel like
it will dissolve. Like, it will dissolve.
It'll disappear.
Hey, you know. Do I take this and dab it off and check and do it again or what?
Where you can it? Rub it, just scrub it off, and then you can reuse the stone.
Okay, do it again real quick.
So once you put the acid on, once the acid goes on it, then you wipe the acid off?
I know.
Here, is this the part
just
I'm doing?
Go.
Okay.
Get a Q-tip. Okay. Oh, no. Try it again.
Okay. Folks, I'm trying to get it in here.
I'll hold it in there.
Okay.
I'll get a Q-tip.
Just don't rub it too hard. I mean, if you rub it too hard, it's going to rub it off. So I don't know how you would do that. I didn't do it like that.
I did. I rubbed it hard on accident.
I don't know how you don't rub it hard, though. I guess it's an acquired
drop the
thing.
Acid on it.
Just one dot.
Do it on towards the end, not the, like, yeah. Okay. And then, should I move it with this, with a Q-tip?
Scratch the touchstone and then, with the tip of the acid bottle, rub the acid over the mark.
Don't push more in. Okay.
Looks like it's still there.
It's still there.
You're good. I think that's a good test.
Real gold will not rub off. I have to clean my touchstone with sandpaper to remove the metal, says Bonnie.
Yeah.
It's still there, but I think if I do this, I could probably rub it off. Should I test it with a Q-tip?
I think it's good. I think it's a good test in my opinion, but that doesn't mean
worst case. Yeah, we just
here,
it's real.
We'll test it with something that's not.
What if it is?
No.
And then y'all can test higher.
There, in my opinion, on that too.
What's
so we need to rub it with something.
Let me see.
Okay, so that just disintegrates completely.
Yeah,
but
totally.
I think that will too.
Yeah, it will rub it off.
I don't know. Maybe it's not. I have no idea.
I would just take it to the jeweler.
Yeah, we got to at least find out if these pearls.
I don't know. I disagree, guys. Like, because I know that when I tested my gold, I rubbed it and I could rub it off with the acid on there. And when I brought it into to the coin guy, they ran the same test and they paid me for gold. I think you might be rubbing too hard, but I don't know. I'm not an expert.
Well,
that was my wedding ring, and it disappeared.
Yeah.
The same way.
So maybe, yeah.
I don't know. The thing comes so clean, this stone. I don't know how to know.
It's not a big deal, though. I think we do like Lonnie said. We go get a check. They'll say, check, yay or nay.
Okay.
Right.
So now when
Sorry, Tonya, for dragging this out.
I have a question about a jeweler. You would just go to a local guy.
Uh-oh.
Another.
I would go to a reputable jeweler in your area. I would definitely ask around. I wouldn't just go to the first jeweler I saw, right? I would ask around, maybe like in Facebook groups or something for your area. and see what they recommend.
But like a big jeweler place, like Jared's jeweler place or whatever, would they buy jewelry? I need to be a little guy.
Yeah, that's a good point. So you might want to check out the jewelers in your area that you know, advertise that they do buy the gold.
Okay.
I would check them out, definitely. So a question that's been brought up is, should we have a part two of the show? So this is our pilot episode, if you will. So we really had no idea what to expect and how things were going to go. Clearly, it does take a little bit longer. So what are you thinking, Angie? StevenSteph, do you feel like you guys have enough, like...
Oh my gosh. Look.
Okay. So my suggestion would be that maybe we do a part two and maybe pick out like 10 to 15 pieces.
That's a good idea.
Yeah. And that's what we'll tell everybody in the future too, to go ahead and open the jar and have their jewelry pieces ready.
Yeah.
Let's get clicking once so and part three and part four.
Well, we've got more jars after this. So
next time we'll be taking a look at this.
And if anybody's
diamond encrusted bangimabobber flower ring.
That's hideous.
Tonya, you better wrap this up. It's 12:09.
Oh my gosh, my kids are going bananas. So,
okay.
I was going to say, if anybody wants to know how to test gold, Lonnie Garage Flips has a really good video on that too.
Yeah, but it's not. I'm not the expert, so please. It's just me, like, and doing it for the first time.
And none of us are experts. We're all here to learn.
Yeah. So,
Oh my goodness.
We gotta go. Okay. Thank you, Tonis, for having us on your channel, and we are looking forward to your new show with you and Angie, Treasured Vantage.
Lonnie,
thumbs up.
Thank you, Lonnie.
Everybody out there, enjoy your life.
Okay, so I just wanted to say there are a couple jewelry groups I'd love for you guys to go join on Facebook. Mine is Thrifty Jewelry Treasures, and Bonnie's is Jewelry Junkies Corner. She's also super knowledgeable in jewelry, and I love getting her take on things and her advice. And I want to thank everybody for joining us today. We'll be announcing a part two soon, I think, right, StevenSteph, Angie, part two?
Sure.
So just pick out like 10 to 15 pieces that you are really interested in that you think you might be able to sell. Does that sound good?
Okay.
Let's do it. Do it.
All right. I want to thank everybody for joining us. I'm sorry we're having to cut it short. You know, my kids are off all week because of the hurricanes. So the next video we do, they will be at school. So we won't have to worry about these interruptions. I'm so sorry, guys.
We're glad you're safe.
Yep.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you to everybody for joining us. I really appreciate it. And we will see you in the next one. Oh, and real quick, I put everybody's link to their YouTube channels in the description box down below. So everybody go subscribe to our guest, and we will see you in the next one. Thanks for watching us, guys. Bye.
Bye, guys. Bye.